Okay, hello dear friends, let's continue, and this time I will do a round leaf. Let's see, we will start from here, just how about this? So we will use the small brush instead of torturing ourselves with this large brush. A bit too much water. Take it. This is a way to take the water. Oh, I got a piece of something dirty in my. So I first decide where I put my stem. The top one could be smaller. Use this brush to absorb the excess color. See, it absorbs a lot. Okay. You want it to be flow first, and then you want it to be dried. Does not have to be perfect, right? Because I'm not perfect. So we do this side first, one side at a time. Will be fun. Will be good. Let's just hope everything will turn out to be good eventually. Very light color. I love it. It's more a meditation class instead of a painting class. What do you think? You put your time in painting, you will have not that much time in worry, because you only have this much time. That's my philosophy. Get yourself busy in painting, you will not worry about other things, because your brain is just don't have that power. Okay, kind of fun. This is a little bit too. Shall we have some overlapping? some darker, some lighter. This should be smaller, larger, smaller, more interesting. This part. Okay. Ooh. Is that good? Is that important? If it is good, let it be. Okay, hello dear friends, let's do another leaf design. Get my brush ready and always try on a piece of testing paper. I have a habit to wear this sleeve warmer. It's a little bit not so pretty, but so comfortable, so I will use it. So this one we will do this way, okay. Let's do it. My idea, one from here, not exactly in the middle, a little bit on one side. Let's go. Not in a rush, not in a rush. Can you see me? So as you can see, I use this as a guide, as a rest. Okay, this we will do it relatively free. Okay, here we will do an, okay, this is the right size. We will do another one, one from here, one from here. Okay, not exactly in the middle. That should be good. Okay, we will use a little bit darker color. Blending some darker color. But before we try it, we always try it on a piece of paper. That should be good. This brush should be good. Okay, the wind blow this way, go, 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 go. So if you do Chinese calligraphy, you will know very well how to do it. Quite dark. This one, we will get it darker because it will interwoven. This is better. This is a little bit. Okay, let's do another one. I have tried many times and every time failed. So one from here, the other one from here. Not too much, two of them. Okay, the first one, the larger one, we make it a little bit lighter, and the small one we make it darker. This one we will use darker color. So what we can learn from this, if we put all these three side by side, we can see the problem of each one and the strengths of each one. This one is, this is too thick, so it overtake the power of the leaf. This one is just too cramped up, and this is relatively better with stretching out with the color, but these three are just too uniformly the same, so it's kind of a sore patch of this this piece of design. But anyway, it's a learning process. So next time when you do it, you will think about some large, some small, some dark, some light, make it more interesting, right? Okay, let's just do it. Stop it here.